Well, actually, we've been very, very happy with the index inclusion decision today. We believe that it is the ultimate stamp of approval by the global investor community in terms of the readiness of the Saudi market to attract and to accommodate foreign investors, especially since this came in the very same year that FTSE made its decision earlier this year. What has actually given us more comfort and more confidence is with respect to the MSCI decision. Saudi Arabia has actually been the shortest country that has spent time on the watch list. We were admitted to the watch list in June of last year. The index inclusion was made this year. With having spent a year on the watch list, Saudi Arabia is today the shortest country that has ever spent time on the watch list before an index inclusion decision has been made.
And this is in spite of the fact that there have been some questions raised, of course, about Saudi Arabia governance and what happened at the Ritz-Carlton last year. This hasn't slowed the process down.
Well, we actually take that's the nice thing about capital markets, is that they're a real-time barometer of how the investor community, local and international, views the attractiveness of investing in the country. And with respect to the incidents in late last year, we did see a slight decline immediately after the announcements were made, but shortly thereafter, by about December, we were back to the same levels in terms of foreign investor participation, so that by early January, we were actually hitting new highs in terms of the rate and the quantum of foreign investors who were coming in. So we took this as the ultimate barometer of how the global investor community feels and views Saudi Arabia.
So we've talked about the global investor community in terms of that being a barometer of success, but what about the private sector inside Saudi Arabia? It's been a couple of years of slow growth in terms of private sector investment, a lot of hesitancy to get back into the market following those couple of years of lower oil prices. Where do you see the private sector going forward now in terms of investing in the market?
Well, so from our standpoint as the capital market regulator, one of the most important barometers that we look at in terms of the performance of the private sector is the earnings of private sector companies. And those have actually ticked up in the past period, largely driven by both banks and the petrochemicals industry. But we took this as an important signal of the level of profitability of the private sector. Now, obviously, on the other hand, there is some uncertainty whenever you have a massive reform undertaking at the level of entire country. And our belief is with simply time and with a lot of the dust settling in terms of the new regulations kicking in and coming into force, I think we will start to see capital flow. And one event that is likely to trigger this is an index decision like this today.
Talk to me a little bit about the Aramco IPO. Earlier today, we heard from His Excellency Khaled Al-Falah, the oil minister, basically saying, of course, yet again, that the primary listing or the prime will be on the Tadawul for the Aramco IPO. Can you give us a sense of the timeline there? There's been so much movement in just the last 3 years in terms of getting ready for this MSCI inclusion for the emerging market index. What's happening next with that IPO?
So from our standpoint as the capital market regulator, we like to remain at an arm's length with respect to the inclusion decision, with respect to the listing timing decision, and with respect to the venue selection decision.
But you're ready.
But we are ready. The final piece of the puzzle that we are currently working on is a set of price stabilization regulations, which is the last piece of regulation that is currently missing if one wanted to do an offering of the size, scale, and scope of Saudi Aramco. That is currently in the pipeline. We've already gone out to public consultation with a draft set of regulations and are likely to issue the final set within the next month or so. And with that, we can say that the entire ecosystem from a regulatory standpoint is ready to accommodate a listing of any size or scale.
What about oil price stability? Because the conversation that's happening right now at OPEC in Vienna, a lot of questions over whether or not we're going to see that price stability going forward, $80 versus $55, where is it going to go? For the Aramco listing and for the Tadawul generally, where do you see an appropriate oil price?
So as a market regulator, I've learned not to try and predict the future. It is almost like asking a referee what the score of an eventual game in the World Cup is likely to be. We put up our hands and say we just make sure that the playing is fair and the rules are appropriate.
Hey everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.